when we're static stretching, we're just making a change at the neurological level. Mm-hmm. So we're just changing kind of our nervous system's perception of that stretch.
Which is probably where that placebo is derived from.
Yes. So basically, we're not going to lengthen the muscle. It's going to be at the nervous system, and possibly the protective mechanisms are being turned off. So like stretch reflex, what Corey was talking about when he was on here, Corey Schlesinger was talking about with static stretching, we're dampening the stretch reflex and the GTOs. Mm-hmm. These are protective mechanisms. They're there for a reason. So what, we think we're smarter than our body?
Yeah.
Like, oh, you're there for a reason, but I'm going to turn you off. We don't need you. So that could be another explanation, is that you're kind of, you don't necessarily turn them off, but you dampen them and you push them to a lower point. So now when your muscle starts to lengthen, instead of that stretch reflex kicking in and then leading to a more explosive contraction, or leading to more co-contraction to lead to stability, which we want, like if the foot is hitting down to make a hard cut, we want that stretch reflex to kick on so that we have enough co-contraction for stability. So if we turn that off, now we got to sink lower and lower and lower into our joints to then get that same stretch reflex. What we just talked about with increasing length, right, at the muscular level, static stretching probably doesn't really do it. There are some methods that actually do increase muscle length or muscle fiber length. Eccentric training is the number one way, particularly full range of motion. Eccentric training is the number one way to increase the length. And when I say length, I mean increasing the sarcomeres in series. So you don't make the muscle longer because it has its certain origin and insertion, but you're making the muscle fibers literally longer. And so that we could call that more of a plastic change. What was the study? I think I've seen a few studies. Maybe I have it in here. But basically, they did only two sessions, and they separated them by 8 days. So they did a full range of motion, eccentric training session. 8 days later, they did it again. And I think that length lasted for like 24 days before it reverted back.
That's interesting.
Yeah, so it's pretty strong. And yeah, then you look at the studies of doing like 4 weeks of full range of motion, eccentric training. Mm-hmm. It's like pretty serious. Your sustained length. It's not something like that just reverts back right away. Because like flexibility, how many times have you been out there stretching and then you take a week off and you're right back to where you were before?
Even the next morning, I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah. Nothing is permanent with static stretching. Okay, so if you're interested in more muscle length, eccentric training, full range of motion, eccentric training is probably your best bet. And we'll talk about the other methods, the FRC and the other good stuff.